In this video, I'll talk about some special cases of linear programming problems and how to identify their characteristics in the Simplex tableau. We may face the following cases of linear programming problems. Case 1, some linear programming problems may have a unique optimal solution. Case 2, if a linear programming problem has two or more optimal extreme points, all the points that are on the line between these two points are also optimal, so the problem has an infinite number of optimal solutions. Case 3, some linear programming problems may be infeasible. Case 4, some linear programming problems may be unbounded. That means they can take arbitrarily large z values for maximization problems or arbitrarily small z values for minimization problems. Case 5, some linear programming problems are degenerate, which means they have redundant constraints that can be removed without affecting the feasible region. When we use the Simplex method to solve these linear programming problems, we may notice some special patterns in the Simplex tableau. It should be noted that the examples I show in this video are all maximization problems. For minimization problem, we can convert it into a maximization problem by maximizing the opposite of the objective function. This is a linear programming problem with two variables, and we can solve it using the graphic method. The optimal solution is a single point, 3, 3. The optimal z value is 15. This is the corresponding optimal tableau. We find that all non-basic variables have positive coefficients in row 0. It turns out that this rule is generally applicable to all linear programming problems with a unique optimal solution. If we modify the objective function and change this coefficient from 3 to 4, then we can find in this figure that we will have an infinite number of optimal solutions between 0.33 and 0.4.50. Now let's check this optimal tableau. It corresponds to this point in the figure. We have a non-basic variable with a coefficient of 0 in row 0. It is an indicator that we may have another optimal solution. Let's proceed one more step anyway, using x2 as the entering variable. We find that this is also an optimal solution. It corresponds to this point. It has the same z value. We know that if two points are optimal, then any point on the line segment joining these two points will also be optimal. Therefore, we have an infinite number of optimal solutions. A linear programming problem may be infeasible. For a maximization problem, this situation does not occur when all the constraints are less than or equal to with non-negative right-hand side, because all slack variables provide an obvious feasible solution. This situation occurs in the Big M method and the two-phase method in which artificial variables are used. In this example, the right-hand side of the first constraint is 4, and the second constraint has a greater than or equal to sign. If in the optimal tableau at least one artificial variable is positive like this, then the linear programming problem is infeasible. This is the case that the linear programming problem is unbounded. The constraints are two greater than or equal to constraints. This is the feasible region, and the z value can be infinitely large. When we do this simplex iteration, at some point, the entering variable has a non-positive coefficient in each constraint, so we cannot proceed. This is the indicator that the problem is unbounded. The last case we will talk about is called degeneracy. It is caused by one or more redundant constraints and may cause the simplex method extra iterations. A redundant constraint is a constraint that can be removed without changing the feasible region. In this example, the last constraint, x1 is less than or equal to 4.5, is a redundant constraint. We can see that from this figure. The feasible region will not change if we remove this constraint. Formally, a linear programming problem with n discrete variables is degenerate if at least n plus 1 constraints, including the sign restrictions, are binding at an extreme point. In this case, we have n is equal to 2 variables, and there are three constraints that are binding at this point. It is an intersection of three lines, this one, and this one. Let's see what will happen during the simplex iteration. This is the initial simplex tableau. The initial basic feasible solution corresponds to this extreme point in the figure. x1 is the entering variable because it has the most negative coefficient in row 0. After we calculate the ratio, we find that we have a tie. This is an indicator that this might be a degenerate linear programming problem. We break the tie arbitrarily and now we pick this row as the pivot row. This is the updated tableau. It corresponds to this point. We moved from the initial extreme point here to this point. The z value is increased from 0 to 27 over 2. Note that we have a basic variable equal to 0. This is another indicator that the linear programming problem is degenerate. x2 will be the entering variable, and this row will be the pivot row. This is the updated tableau. It means we move from this point to itself. The z value didn't improve. It is still 27 over 2. We still have a basic variable equal to 0. Now we definitely know we have a degenerate linear programming problem. Let's continue with the simplex iteration. S3 will be the entering variable, and this row will be the pivot row. This is the updated tableau. It corresponds to this point. It means we moved from this point to this point. The z value is improved from 27 over 2 to 15. This is the optimal tableau, and we have a unique optimal solution because all the coefficients of non-basic variables are positive. Therefore, degeneracy could cause the simplex method extra iterations. If a linear programming problem has many degenerate basic feasible solutions, then the simplex algorithm is often very inefficient. In this example, we are lucky and continuing the process leads to the last optimal tableau. In some problems, degeneracy can cause the solution to cycle indefinitely, and the simplex algorithm may fail to reach the final optimal solution. Fortunately, some degenerate linear programming problems have a special structure that enables us to solve them by methods other than the simplex. Okay, we talked about some special cases of linear programming problem solutions and how to identify them in the simplex tableau. Thanks for watching.